I'm a little bit pissed off, see?
Why?
You know why? Because Hateful Eight was not nominated for an Oscar.
Well, I think that's not a problem.
What do you mean it's not a problem?
Or Tarantino.
It's about time Tarantino gets recognized for his incredible work. I mean, he's like Hitchcock in so many ways.
You're talking about a lifetime achievement, not this film.
I'm not talking about lifetime achievement. I'm talking about a genius at the prime of his career. Hitchcock set new standards. He said he shifted the paradigm of filmmaking. Tarantino's one of them. He's got that distinct filmmaking style.
You're talking about him generally, not this film. This film was not his best film. Too much dialogue.
I'm not saying it's his best, but if you compare it to a lot of the films that came out this year, I think it's one of the strongest ones.
It should have been up there, but I don't think it has a hope. Had it been nominated, but
I,
on the other hand, I'm on my way to the Oscars, Fred.
Are you?
And a very sneak preview, an inside job got me, an inside contact got me the absolutely exclusive best film winner here. We
What's
have the
there?
Information of all these nominees.
Yeah.
We have it here. I'll be revealing
I wasn't even trying to take
it
off of
you. A bit later, we'll check that out and we'll see.
Okay, okay.
What the best one is. It's in there. We'll be able to see.
So the Oscars for best films included The Big Short.
Yep.
Bridge of Spies, my personal favorite.
Yeah.
Brooklyn. Mad Max Fury Road.
Yep.
The Martian. The Revenant. Room. And Spotlight. That was a disturbing movie, man.
It was.
Spotlight was true. And it had to be made.
It did.
It really had to be made because not enough films explore the issue of child abuse. I mean, it is such a big thing, and particularly in the last couple of years when so many priests have been exposed for wrongdoing. I mean,
it was very well done.
Very
good.
Incredible. And probably the best cast of the year.
Tom McCarthy.
Better even than Hateful Eight.
Yeah. Tom McCarthy up for Best Director, so we'll see how he goes on that one. So
who's in the film?
Should be quite good.
You got Rachel McAdams.
Yeah.
Michael Keaton. I love Michael Keaton.
Michael Keaton apparently based his role on Jason Robards in All the President's Men, which is very similar.
It makes sense. Yeah, he was the editor.
And why didn't Michael Keaton get nominated? So that's another. Yeah. This is the thing. Every year it's the same thing. The Oscars, the biggest game in town, but it works in strange ways. So I always think there should be two parallel areas of contention. One, and many people say this, what will win the Oscar? Because the Oscars work in strange ways. And what should win the Oscars on merit? For example, what's your take on this big campaign by the black people? There's not, of all the 20 acting nominations,
there's
no...
That is such rubbish. Who cares?
There's no black actors.
But you know what that implies to me? Mm. It implies to me that just because we're inclusive now and tolerant or whatever have you, we have to include a black actor in an Oscar nomination. Is that what they're saying? No, are we going to include a black actor regardless of whether he or she deserved it or not?
This is what it boils down to. I tend to agree.
That's what it boils down to, exactly. Even Michael Caine came forward and said, who cares? What are you talking about? In this particular year...
The merit.
Yeah.
Is there.
In this particular year, a black actor, unfortunately, was not considered because... none of them performed.
Samuel Jackson, best support? I don't think he's quite there.
Samuel Jackson is brilliant.
He was very good, but not quite there. Up with the like Tom Hardy.
Yeah.
It was very good for what he was doing in Mad Max. Tom Hardy in Revenant.
Hardy in two movies this year.
Two competing
Mad
movies.
Max and Revenant. And he could win either.
He wasn't nominated for Mad Max, of course. So he was virtually a supporting role there. But
How funny is that?
He's
Mad
so good.
Mad Max is a supporting role in his own movie.
Yeah.
Charlize Theron was practically the main actress in the film.
Well, let's talk about Max a bit. You know, that's her best actor. And also, I'm just bored with that movie. I forgot all the other Maxes. I didn't think it was good at all.
I don't think it was boring. I just thought it was a literal remake of The Road Warrior.
It was... just a long road movie. Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, it had a few good things. Charlize Theron, as you said, was brilliant. She was very good.
She's
up for Best Actor.
Yeah, it's
80% of it, the stunts, 80% of the makeup and the sets were all real. The CGI, it was just that was good. But the movie itself didn't do anything for me.
You know,
it was just one big chase.
Yeah.
Like I said, much like Road Warrior.
Yeah.
So I'm not clear that's going to be.
When I walked out of that film, I wasn't too impressed. I mean, it's a good action film. In its own right, it's a very beautifully made film. The cinematography is fantastic, and the production values far exceed the original Mad Max films, and obviously he's got far more resources in making it.
George Miller.
I mean, George Miller made Happy Feet since then, and Lorenzo's Oil, and Babe. So he's grown in Hollywood, he's made a name for himself.
That'll do, Pig. I love that. But
you know, if they brought back Mel Gibson, it would have been so much better.
I don't know, because Max in this movie plays virtually a supportive role. Yeah. Mel Gibson, he's a star. But Mad Max has got 10 nominations.
So is Tom Hardy. Tom Hardy's in everything now. He's so big, he's so popular.
He was support there. Very little. Not a lot of character development.
Very busy. Very busy.
But you think Mad Max has got 10 nominations, and Revenant has got 12. But, you know, when we look at the Oscar lineup, I think there's so many things that are Revenant, which are just so good, you know. Yeah. Iñárritu is just... And the problem that's going to hold him up is he won Best Actor and Best Director for last year.
Yeah. You know, well, that shouldn't be an impediment. I mean, he's a great director, and he should be rewarded for his hard work.
But Birdman won last year, and I really think, personally, I'll say it right now, Iñárritu should be winning the actor for Best Actor and Best Film, but Iñárritu won it last year for both, and that the Oscars might hold him back because it could spread around.
Do you think the reason why Michael Keaton wasn't nominated this year was because of Birdman? You think it has something to do with it?
Yeah? Could well be. The Oscars work in strange ways.
Although Meryl Streep is not new to the Oscars. I mean, she has been nominated countless times. I don't even know how many times she's been nominated. Like 15 times?
Heaps.
So I don't think it really plays much of a role. I think if a performance or a film is great, it's rewarded accordingly.
And how about Room? Room was...
Room! Yes, I wanted to mention that.
Unbelievable film.
I only saw that recently.
Oh,
what an original film.
Yeah.
Not in the subject matter that it explores.
Just right in
but
there.
But the way the narrative of the story unfolds. Mm. It starts in a room, and like a pyramid, it just gets bigger and bigger and bigger. So you start from a very confined space, as opposed to other films which start...
It doesn't go up. You got this woman and her son, and that's it, the whole thing. You barely see the guy that held them totally captive. That one room is the whole thing, until towards the end, it develops a bit.
You know what I was thinking for the first half of the film while they were in that room? Mm-hmm. I was thinking Bad Boy Bubby.
I was
thinking this is a shithouse remake of the Australian film Bad Boy Bubby, but it turned out to be completely different. And you know what? That's, again, one of the strongest films of the year.
I was
totally blown away. But the one thing that really got under my skin and towards the end of the film was when William H. Macy, the father of the girl who has been locked up for 7 years, he's not explored much at all. There is a little disagreement at the dinner table. He walks off and you never hear from him again. And there is no resolution. There is no closure between her father and her.
It wasn't his film. It was really them.
Yeah.
I mean, Jacob Tremby, the kid, he's only 9 years old. It's a great role with the long hair and everything. Yeah. Why wasn't he nominated?
And there are many films like it. Hmm. But how many films begin in the room as if it's kind of like a science fiction movie? You don't know what's going on in the outside world.
No windows.
It's almost like they're in a spaceship.
This kid's whole existence, he was born there. That's all he knows. He's 9 years old,
crazy.
He goes through it. Brie Larson, that woman is fantastic.
Yeah, I've never seen her before. What other films has she been in?
I'm not sure. Yeah. She should be best actor, female, I think, for her. She was great. Okay, what else we got? Brooklyn.
I've not seen Brooklyn. Tell me about it. Is it a good film? Is it Oscar worthy?
No, I think Charlize Ronan was good. She was put in soft focus.
She was in Hannah, wasn't she?
She was.
She was the assassin with Eric Bana.
She's a young girl in 50s Ireland, and she goes across to America to find a better life, and she meets this young Italian boy, and they have a budding relationship, and they build up, and she needs to go back home to Ireland. It's just before that he says, well, why don't we just get married real quick? You'll come back. Mm-hmm. And then when she's back home, her mother's pushing her into another relationship. She can't decide. It's a bit of a romance. And very similar.
Oh, food's ready.
Very nice. Oh, yes, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Beautiful.
Yum, yum, yum. Pickle.
Sorry. Bridge of Spy was so good with Tom Hanks and Mark Rylance. beautiful. Mark Rylance is the captured spy in Bridge of Spies. Was so good. He was just brilliant. You know,
in my opinion, it's the finest production of the year. The attention to detail in Bridge of Spies, the real locations, Spielberg's epic photography.
Yep.
There was something so subtle and forced about it. It kind of felt like things were happening in real time. Bridge of Spies. It wasn't like an edge of your seat action film, although a lot of the things that happened during that time, during the Cold War, when we didn't know if the world was going to end tomorrow in a third war, a nuclear holocaust. And the way Spielberg shows the players in this prisoner exchange, this spy exchange that they have, you feel as though these men are pieces on a chessboard. They're so powerful. Any minute mistake could turn out to be to have drastic effects.
Totally.
You know what I mean? Spielberg is so good at creating that feeling as though every one of these people are the most important people in the world, you know?
But Spielberg was not nominated for Best Director.
Martian was nominated for Best Comedy at the Golden Globes. Can you explain that to me? It doesn't make any sense whatsoever. In what way, shape or form, Martian could be nominated and winning at the Golden Globes Best Comedy of the Year? How is it a comedy?
It's easy.
It's a drama.
Of course.
With comic elements in it.
It makes sense for this reason. You're exactly right, and everyone else is the gas. It's the way the Golden Globes works. Their categories change around a bit, and they have the best comedy or a different film in that area, and that they couldn't nominate it for the other one because they wanted a, you know, it's the politics. Put it in another area and has a better chance of winning, which it did. It wasn't a comedy. There, as you say, there were comedic elements, but I think that film, personally, was not nearly as good as the book. It's always a way, but it was quite good. I mean,
Room had more comedy in it.
Well, yeah, but no, it was pretty horrific. But getting back to The Martian, Ridley Scott, brilliant director. He wasn't nominated for Best Director.
Although, I think you would agree with me, Sig. This is Ridley Scott's major comeback. He has not made a great film in a long, long time.
Yeah, I'm with you on that one, for sure.
Prometheus was a piece of crap.
Oh, no, it was garbage.
That was the worst bridge for the alien universe I've ever seen. Made by the man who created it.
The Martian is a comeback for Ridley Scott, but I don't know whether I tend to agree it's not really the best film, and I don't have a hope. It's not really his best, but he's
definitely not the best.
Returning, yeah.
But
Matt
as
Damon
a great,
was so good.
Absolutely. Look, as a great science fiction movie, it fits that category perfectly. And look, there are not many science fiction films out this year. But in terms of Ridley Scott's body of work, he's back in form, you know?
He is, yeah, Ridley Scott.
He's back to what he does best.
Exactly. I mean, what about the films that didn't get nominated? What about the people that didn't get nominated? I mean, like we've talked about a few, Steven Spielberg and Tarantino and Mad Max, of course, has done well with many nominations, but I got Mad Max.
What a great comeback for
Mad Max was.
George Miller.
Yeah.
George Miller's producer, Doug Mitchell, who's worked with him on pretty much all of his movies, and a lot of some of the most famous Australian TV productions like Dirt World, Water Dynasty, Bangkok Hilton. He made Dead Calm as well. He's one of the most prolific Australian producers.
We have mentioned. Yes, we talked about The Big Short before.
I really don't understand how Big Short was nominated for Best Film. Explain it to me. I need to watch that film at least 3 times to understand what the hell is going on. There is just so much information, so many characters, all of them are with conflicting interests.
Yeah, and it's quite detailed and quite complicated.
So
all the
detailed,
financial
so going much to... jargon, even though there are segments in the film where they make an effort to explain to people what's going on. You have no bloody idea what's going on.
And they do it well. Like one scene in a bathtub, they're sort of going on.
Margot Robbie.
Yeah, explaining what's going on.
And there was
on.
Also Selena Gomez at a casino.
That's right.
It was some cool cameos there. But it didn't it didn't make the 2006-2007 global financial crisis meltdown interesting.
Oh, I think it did.
Did it?
Oh, for sure,
I spent most of the film trying to work out what the hell is going on.
It was compelling. The fact that it happened, and it was complicated. You really have to keep your wits about you. And just said, consistent viewing, or consecutive viewing might be wise, but it was informative, and it was you know, quite entertaining, and had a narrative progression as well. You could follow it and get a bit interested, but it was very complicated.
You know what I find fascinating? Christian Bale is nominated for an Oscar. I do not believe his performance was even close to being the best. Steve Carell was the standout. He stole out every scene in a movie, which is a drama.
In The Big Short.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's a drama. It's one of his first, if not the first, real drama film he started.
For a comedian.
For a comedian. And he steals every scene. He's this financial...
He was in that wrestler film.
Oh, yes. That's where he had the modified nose.
Yeah, that was brilliant. What was that film? With Channing Tatum.
Channing Tatum.
That was a good one. He was quite good. And Mark Ruffalo. Yeah, Mark Ruffalo, again, you know, he was nominated for his role in
Spotlight.
Spotlight. And
he was excellent in that as well.
I think Mark Rylance was just so good in Bridge of Spies. He should go in for Best Supporting Actor. You know, it's just,
what happened to Rachel McAdams? She was like really big for a short period of time.
It's another omission.
And you just... No, but I'm saying... You don't hear about her anymore. She's kind of disappeared off the limelight.
You're only as good as your last movie, so...
She's such a beautiful and talented actress.
She's a good actor, yeah. You know? A beautiful woman that can also act. Mm. We'll get calls.
I loved her in what was that Wes Craven movie where she's on a plane? Red Eye.
Red Eye.
She was in Red Eye, Notebook. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Quite good. But Carol was another good film. I was just blown away by Carol with Cate Blanchett and Rooney Mara. Mm-hmm. Just sort of luminous scene, great. Cate Blanchett could do no wrong. That was not nominated. Mm. She was not nominated. She's had her chance.
See, I did not enjoy Carol at all.
Why? You didn't like it? Tell me why.
Oh, look, I love lesbian overtones. Don't get me wrong. She's very beautiful. Both
Cate Blanchett.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
I think Cate Blanchett is a very beautiful one. And everyone played their roles really well.
It's a budding romance. It's the building, budding relationship between the two, and the complexities in the 50s when it's just not done. They had to be undercovers and secret, and the turmoil that both women went to become close, and yet they wanted to be close, and the difficulty they had with their other workmates, family, and friends. To me, it was fascinating.
But see, I didn't feel that there were tensions and dichotomies between their relationship and society around them.
Oh, really?
I didn't feel it.
Not at all.
It wasn't explored in depth at all.
Oh, no. I disagree. They really, I could feel the tension between them. Some of the stuff going on, you know, that was so difficult for them to do what they were doing. And she was a very subdued Cate Blanchett. You could almost smell the perfume coming off. It's incredible. And I really felt for them. They're trying to get together, trying to get going, and they just couldn't in the 50s.
She's an amazing actress, amazing.
Stunning. Rooney Mara, of course, played the Dragon Tattoo so well in the remake.
But I don't think it's Oscar-worthy.
I tend to agree. And no way she get it, because the way the Oscars work, Cate Blanchett has had a few. Even if she was deserving, then she won't get it. Now, that's the other thing. Getting back to Best Actor, I really think that no one can touch Leonardo DiCaprio in The Revenant. He was just so good in Iñárritu's movie. However, they may think the sympathy vote. You know, he's such a good actor. He's been in it for a long time.
And a lot of people are pressuring the Oscars to give him
final. He could get it just because his body of work. He could get it because he never had one. He could get the sympathy vote. It could go through. And I think that's a travesty.
It's almost become part of folklore now in Hollywood. Leo hasn't won an Oscar. Leo hasn't won an Oscar.
But he did so good in this. He deserved, to me, he deserved. Who do you think should get Best Actor? Better than Leonardo. I mean, I just think he's a walk-in, personally.
I love Tim Roth in Hateful Eight. He was amazing.
He was good.
Tim Roth is amazing in every film he's in. I thought Steve Carell was brilliant in A Big Short, even though I had no idea what the hell was going on in that movie. Tom Hanks was brilliant in Bridge of Spies. I would probably agree with you. DiCaprio this year is the stronger one. And well, I also agree with him not being nominated or, sorry, not winning in the past either, because in the years that he was nominated for his work, he was outclassed by his competition. This year, though, he is very strong, and I believe he should win. Absolutely. It's an amazing film because a lot harder, I believe, than a traditional movie where there's a lot of dialogue, because in this one, he had to express so much emotion physically.
Yeah.
Without speaking.
Yeah. And most of the time, he's on his own.
Absolutely.
It's like Tom Hanks. Excuse me. Like Tom Hanks on an island.
Yeah, yeah.
With the volleyball.
Oh, Wilson. But he talked a lot in Castaway. Yeah. To himself, obviously.
Well, just to himself, yeah.
Yeah. That volleyball should have won an Oscar.
Good. Best supporting role. Best supporting role goes to the volleyball. Some of the films that didn't quite get in, you know, yeah. Singular. For example, Creed, you know, I mean,
Creed.
And Stallone.
I don't think Creed was Oscar worthy at all. I mean, we talked about this.
Yeah.
It's virtually a remake of the original film.
But it's very good, though. I mean,
very good.
It's right up there.
Great production values. Yeah. Michael B. Jordan should have at least been nominated.
Well, there's one black actor that should have been nominated, possibly.
Absolutely.
But you know, when you're up against someone like Leonardo DiCaprio and someone like, we haven't even talked
about
it. But
at least nominated. We can agree on that. Yeah.
We haven't even talked about Michael Fassbender in Jobs. I mean, it was...
Are you kidding me? That was a terrible movie. I watched it last night.
I think it was pretty average, too. You know,
it
pretty
was
straightforward.
So average.
But he was nominated.
Look... The Steve Jobs movie, it barely covered even a fraction of his career.
No, just...
It concentrated on the Mac, launch of Next, the Next computer.
Yep.
And the iMac. When
the Mac,
came out.
iMac. Yep.
Didn't even get to the iPod or the iPhone. I preferred the Ashton Kutcher movie called Jobs that came out a couple of years ago.
That was terrible.
No, it was terrible, but at least it covered his entire career, and it showed... all the things he needed to do to get to where he got.
But Fred, it was such a dog of a movie. Kutcher doing that
terrible movie.
You're right.
Again, we're not going to see a Steve Jobs movie for the performances. We're going to learn about his career.
Mm-hmm.
If we're talking about it from that perspective, the Kutcher movie is far superior because it's like a timeline. It shows you how he was a student, how he thought up of Apple with Wozniak.
Wozniak, yeah.
And then how... year by year, they made progress and became bigger and bigger.
It was not a well-done film to me.
It was not a well-done movie, but I learned so much watching it.
Get out of my documentary. I'm sorry.
Whereas this movie, Fassbender was completely miscast. Looks nothing like the man.
No, it wasn't meant to.
Wasn't meant to.
I agree.
Even the narrative of the film, it concentrated on his relationship with his wife,
daughter
he had an affair with, and the daughter they had together. I don't care. I don't care about that.
It wasn't
Steve
meant to
Jobs
be.
Steve Jobs is interesting only because of Apple. I want to know about how or what he did to make Apple what
it wasn't meant to be a caricature of Steve Jobs. Michael Fassbender is a great actor. And
great actor.
For that role, you know, he was pretty good. But the movie is a bit episodic.
Yeah.
I don't understand, Fred, how it's possible to have a film. The best film and best director, they go hand in hand. A best film has got to be made by someone.
Yeah.
And the best director have to have made a good film. You know, they should go hand in hand. All the nominations should be the same. We've got three films here which haven't been nominated for best director. How can they possibly be nominated for best film when the directors aren't there?
Yeah.
They are very... Sometimes it makes a mockery.
Well, best picture,
you know,
best
sometimes
film
it makes a mockery of the Oscars.
Yeah.
Oscars, when you have a best picture and the best director doesn't win.
Well, best picture is actually producer.
But the picture has got to be made.
Yeah, yeah, true.
By the director, or the producer is the whole overall thing.
Well, producer does a lot of work to make the film. You know.
But it's the director's vision. The producer does a lot of the...
But the producer is the one with the final word. Revenant is definitely one of the three strongest films of the year. But Spielberg, man, he's just consistently a great filmmaker.
True, but he's not in the running.
Yeah.
Well, what do you do? So, Fred, what do you reckon? Let's have a look. This is going to be the one. It's all in here. It's going to be happening. So, the big reveal. Let's have a look. What do you think will win? We're going to find out right now. Drum roll.
Bum, 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 bum. bum ba da bum 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 ba ba bum.
Entertainer, and I know just where I stand. Another serenader and another long-haired band. Today I am your champion. I may have won your hearts, but I know the game, you forget my name, and I won't be here in another year if I don't stay on the charts.